Hello friends, let's start the another problem on the trusses. So let's see in detail problem number 2 on trusses. Now friends, this is a question given to us. Analyze the pin jointed frame by flexibility method as shown in figure. All the members may have the assumes to the same AE is equal to constant. This is 4 meter, this is 4 meter, A, B, C and D. Okay, so let's start the solution. Our first step will be, first we have to check key. Let's start the solution. First step will be degree of static indeterminacy we have to check. Degree of static indeterminacy we have to check first. So this will be DSE is nothing but R minus 3. Your R will be C. R we have to check 2 plus 1, 3. We have to write 3 minus 3 equal to 0. Now we have to check DSI is equal to M minus 2J minus 3. Okay. So M minus 2J minus 3 means member will be, count the member 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6. Member will be 6. Then minus 2 into joint will be 4 minus 3. Okay, 6 minus 8 minus 3, 6 minus 5 is equal to 1. Means total DS will be 0 plus 1 is equal to 1. Means we have a redundant value over here is 1. So our next step will be, our next step is step number 2. Let, we have to remove one part, this name as AC. Let AD be the, sorry, AD not AC. Let AC be the redundant part. Okay, AC be the redundant means we have to remove, we have to remove, remove member, member A and D. Now we have to remove member A and D. Now our third step will be, third step will be P analysis. Draw the diagram as it is. Now see friends, we have removed this AC part and then draw the diagram to find P analysis. Now find all the forces, all the forces at member AB, BC, CD, DB and AD using P analysis. So see, first we have to find the reaction over here. This is your VD, this is your HD and this is VC. Since there is no horizontal, see, or there is only one horizontal load going in this direction, 20 kN, means this is also come in 20 kN. Now to find VD, take moment at C, D, sorry. Taking moment at D is equal to 0, clockwise positive. So we have only the values will be, see, clockwise positive means we are taking bending moment over here. We are taking moment at D over here. Okay, so we have to take moment over here. Okay, so see, this 20 is going in clockwise direction. 20 into this distance is 4 meter. This is also 4 meter. So 20 into 4 positive, 20 into 4 minus VC into 4 is equal to 0, means your VC will be 20 kN comes over here. Okay, now summation Fy equal to 0 upward positive, this will be 20 kN. Fy means VD is going upward, minus 30 plus 20 is equal to 0. Here VD will be 10 kN. Okay friends, see, this 30 is going upward, this 30 is going from downward, this 20 is going in this direction, this 20 is going in, this 20 is going in this direction. Okay, now let's start with the P analysis. Now how will you analyze the P analysis? See, directly you can solve here also, shortcut, you can apply the shortcut. Since See, this 20 is going in this direction. So to oppose this, this will go in this direction. Means two arrows are away from each other is nothing but compression. Means minus 20. So you will write like this directly, okay? Now, see, since there is no load over here at C, at X axis, therefore it will get directly zero. Now see, this 20 is going in this direction. To oppose this, you will apply like this. And this is a, and this is name as, these two arrows are away from each other is nothing but compression. This is also 20 kN. Now here, this is going 30 in this direction. We will apply like this. 30 kN. Okay. Now see, but here we don't know this value D and B. We cannot directly solve this at zero because they are at some value, because this is going 10 upward. This 20 is going outward. So to find this, to apply the joint C. Now apply the condition of equilibrium to joint D. Now let's take the joint D. First draw the FBD of joint D. See, how will you draw, friends? See, you have to draw like this. Okay, now see, at D, at joint D, this is going upward, this is going like this. So you will draw like this. This is 20 and this is 10. Okay, we know this and this value. And we also know this is also we know. 30 kN, okay, and we don't know this value. Means what you have to do, we have to resolve this part like this, and this is your angle. The angle will be 4/4 means 45, and this will be this force will be is nothing but this is PNL, this is PDB. So PDB cos 45, PDB sine 45. Since this is not with respect to angle, that's why sine. This is with respect to angle, therefore it is cos. Okay, now what you have to do, now you have to apply summation fx and summation fy to get the value. So we will apply summation fx first, or you can apply summation fy also. So we'll apply summation fy equal to 0 upward positive. Okay, see, this 10 is going upward means positive, this 30 is going downward minus 30, this is going upward plus PDB sine 45 is equal to 0. Here PDB will be, here PDB will be, friends, we got the PDB value will be 28.28 kilonewton positive. Positive means it is a tension. Now see, we got the value of PDB. Now no need to take the summation fy fx also. So tension is nothing but two arrows are kissing each other. So you will draw like this. Okay, two arrows are kissing each other is nothing but 28.28. Okay, now we have done with this P analysis. Now our fourth step will be K analysis. Fourth step will be K analysis. Fourth step is K analysis. In K analysis, what we are drawing, we are removing all the external forces and draw the diagram as it is and apply 1 kN where we have removed the load. Now see, we are removing this load, so you will apply 1 kN like this. This is 1 kN, this is also 1 kN, this is also 1 kN. Same as it is here also, two arrows are kissing each other. This is also a 1 kN. Now see friends, we start with the K analysis. Now in K analysis, what we have to do, we will remove that part, we will apply 1 kN over here, okay? Now write the values A, B, C and D. Now what you have to do, you have to resolve this 1 kN over here, means this is your theta, and this is theta. Theta is nothing but 45 because it is 4/5, 4/4, okay? 45 degrees is our theta. So how will you resolve? When see, when this 1 kN is resolved over here with respect to theta, this arrow is going in this direction. To oppose this arrow, we will apply arrow in this directions. So we'll apply like this. So always remember, K analysis is always like this only. 1 cos 45 is equal to 0.7. Same here also. Here this is going this direction, to oppose this, this will go in this direction. Okay friends, now right, draw the table. And this is a table given to us. Now let's take this P is nothing but P analysis. So take the table, member AB will be 20 kN compression, because two arrows are away from each other, means we have to write minus 20 over here, because it is compression. Compression is minus 20. Then B and C will be, two arrows are away from each other, is also will write minus 20 over here. This is C and D will be 0. Then D and A will be also away from each other, means 30 kN minus. A and C will be 0. Then D and B will be, two arrows are kissing each other, means tension. So we will write directly 28.28. Friends, this is 28.28. Okay, this is friends 28.28. After that, dealt with P analysis. Now let's come to K. AB will be compression. So minus 0.7. This is also minus 0.7. This is also minus 0.7. This is 1 and this is 1. This is AC. AC will be kissing each other, 1. Then D and B will be also for tension, because two arrows are kissing each other, means 1. This is also get 1. Now L will be, this will 4. And this distance, how will you find this? How will you find this distance? So we'll write length is equal to 4 square plus 4 square is equal to 5.65. This is a length of A, D and B. Okay, so you will write 5.65. Okay, in previous question friends, both the L's are same, all L are same, that's why we are not written the L here. L will be different at the inclined line. Okay, so PKL will be 56 0. Yeah, I have already calculated friends, that's why I'm writing directly 0. Now we have to write this total, the summation PKL, summation K square L will be 35.6.06. This will be 19.16. Okay, R will be, now see, both all R are same. All R are same. The formula of R will be minus summation PKL upon summation K square L upon A is the formula. So you will write like this. 356.06 upon 19.16 will be, answer will be minus 18.58 kN minus is nothing but compression. So our R value will be minus 18.58. All the R values are same. Okay, minus 18.58. After that, R into K, R is minus 18.58 into K. So it will get 13. This is minus 18.58. Okay, now this will be, PF will be P plus RK will come minus 7, 13, 17, minus 18.58, then 9.7. Okay friends, now this is our final answer over, comes over here in this topic. Now after that, we will draw the diagram and update all the forces, minus 7, minus 13, minus 17, minus 18.58, 9.7 in this, all this member. Or I'll remind you first, once again, first key the question. This is a very important 10 marks question friends. It's very important in exam point of view. This is diagram. First check the degree of static indeterminacy. See, if this has come 1, means we have to remove 1 member. We will remove 1 members and apply P analysis, find the reactions, apply or find all the loads, After that key analysis, in key analysis we have to apply 1 kN where we are removing that load. After that just table, and this R will be summation PKL upon AE upon summation K square L upon AE is the formula, but AE will constant over here, that's why we are removing AE over here. Okay, now this is our final answer. I hope you understand this videos and previous videos of the trusses, and yes, don't forget to share with your friends. Thank you.